Give me land, lots of land, under starry skies above. Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze and listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you please, don't fence me in.
You see, it's like this. The cottonwood tree has kind of become a part of my family story. We'll start about 10 years ago when my dad walked out the door of their house in Lafayette and was suddenly struck by the giant cottonwood tree right across the street. Well, Dad became enamored with that tree. Everything from the bark to the leaves to the seasonal changes. Why, if he could, he'd be out every day taking pictures of the cottonwood tree. That's his grandson, my son, acting like a ferocious little beast there. Well, Dad was truly overjoyed by his new discovery, and he set out to find out everything he could about the cottonwood tree. He followed it through the year and studied its biology, its flowers. He was interested to see that there were separate flowers on male and female trees, and the cotton and the seeds that were produced. And he took lots of pictures. Did I mention the pictures he took? He took lots of pictures. Well, he put these all together and actually made a presentation called For Love of a Tree, and he presented that to friends in the neighborhood about 10 years ago. Well, even though I lived most of my adult life out in Virginia, the cottonwood wasn't unfamiliar to me. In fact, the plains cottonwood is a subspecies of the eastern cottonwood. But when I got out here to Colorado, I realized that it was the dominant tree. And they were everywhere. The biggest tree, home to all sorts of wildlife. This robin's got a beak full of worms that she's taken to her nest. And this green metallic bee sitting on a cottonwood leaf is just spectacular. It only makes sense that the great blue heron would choose the cottonwood tree for its rookery. It's the biggest tree around, affords protection from predators. It's right near water most of the time. It's the perfect tree for herons to raise their young. Well, there's my son again. Since that earlier picture we saw, he's grown up a bit. And so has my awareness of this grand tree in our midst. And we'll keep telling stories about the cottonwood, some of which have been told for generations and generations and link us to people in the past.
Hey Dad, what's the story about the star in the cottonwood again?
The story that my son's asking about is the Arapaho Indian story of the star in the cottonwood tree. And it does indeed connect us to people from long ago. So let's tell it.
All things come from Mother Earth. Stars are no exception. They form secretly in the earth and then drift along just under the surface until they find the roots of the magical cottonwood tree. They enter the roots and slowly work their way up through the tree. Finally, they come to rest in the small twigs at the end of the branches. Here they wait patiently until they are needed.
Then, when the spirit of the night sky decides she needs more beautiful stars to light up the heavens, she calls on the wind spirit to help her. The spirit of the wind sends his blustery gusts in all directions. Soon, the wind shakes the magical cottonwood tree so hard that the twigs begin to break off. Then, as each twig breaks away, the stars are released, and even more escape when the twigs break again as they hit the ground.
Now new stars race up into the night sky, where each one is carefully put into a special place. When the spirit of the night sky has enough new stars, she tells the wind spirit to stop. The wind settles down to a nice, gentle night breeze. Of course, the spirit of the night sky wants to thank the wind spirit for his help, so she asks all the new stars to twinkle brightly for him. This way, the wind spirit can see where all the new stars he helped escape have been placed.
I've probably told that story 200 or 300 times over the past few years to my kids and friends and to people who come to programs for Lafayette Open Space. And it's a worthy story to tell because it helps us imagine people that lived here long, long ago. So tell this story to your friends and family. And when you do, have a twig handy to show them how this story probably came to be. On a cottonwood twig, you'll see these knuckle-like wrinkles, and these are called bud scale scars. If you look at a twig, if you find two sets of these scars, that's the amount that the tree grew in 1 year. We'll find a good dry cottonwood twig and snap it open right where the bud scale scar is. And guess what you'll find inside but a star. So I'll end this collection of cottonwood stories by circling back to the story about my dad doing that presentation on cottonwoods for friends and family. My dad's love of this tree rubbed off on me, and I began to see it anew as well. I started to take notice of all sorts of things I hadn't before, from the way the buds swell amazingly fast in the spring, to the wavy pattern of its wood grain, which renders it awfully hard to split, to the way in which a wide variety of animals make use of the size, structure, and shade of the tree. Now I have more stories to tell about the cottonwood, and I hope you'll share those stories too.
Give me land, lots of land, under starry skies above. Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze. And listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you please, don't.